Thank you, Madam Speaker. Members, Congress's 2011 repeal of Don't Ask, Don't Tell ended institutionalized discrimination against gay and lesbian members of the military. And yet today, thousands of individuals still bear the burden of that discrimination. Their military records are tarnished with discharges other than honorable or discharge narratives that reveal their sexual orientation. Therefore, today I rise to present AJR 44, which urges the Department of Defense, Congress, and the President of the United States to create a more efficient process of upgrading the status of those who have been dishonorably or other than honorably discharged from the armed forces of the United States on the basis of their sexual orientation, and to provide benefits, including applicable spousal benefits, to those veterans. Since the Second World War, more than 100,000 service members are estimated to have been discharged from the military for this reason. Depending on the circumstances, many of those forced out of the military may have left with discharge statuses of other than honorable, general discharge, or dishonorable. As a consequence, these service members may be partially or entirely disqualified from accessing benefits that they earned by serving our country. While the Department of Defense has taken important steps by allowing members to appeal their discharge characterization and change their discharge narrative, the process remains onerous for service members, often requiring them to retain legal counsel to help them navigate red tape and produce paperwork and other evidence that service members may not have. The existing discharge review board process is not easy to understand, can take 12 months or more, and places the time, expense, and burden on the discharged individual. This may make sense in other contexts, but to truly undo the damage caused by Don't Ask, Don't Tell and prior policies, it is inequitable to make each and every service member fight his or her own individual battle. Moreover, it is a waste of resources to have the review boards hear the same issue over and over and over again, only to reach the same conclusion. This is an opportunity for us to weigh in on righting a wrong and ask for a more efficient process. I ask for your aye vote.
Mr. Bloom is asking for the first roll be open for co-authors. The clerk will open the roll. This is for co-authors. Fifty-two co-authors are added. The clerk will now open the roll for a vote. All members vote who desire to vote. All members vote who desire to vote. All members vote who desire to vote. Clerk will close the roll, tally the votes. Ayes 56, no 0. The measure is adopted.